One of the biggest Rise of Kingdoms patch is on the way, and luckily we do have early access to it so that I can show you every single upcoming event and we can also discuss the major changes. Without further ado, let's go!
Spartans! What is your profession?
Right, first of all, for my fellow spenders, 10 billion gems, this test account, crazy. We do have recharge event, regular recharge event, and I do have a dedicated guide to get the best value if you are spending in the game. How can you get all the rewards with the minimum amount of spending and of course with the best purchases, so make sure to check it out. Now let's take a look at the upcoming events. First, we have Team Drove. This is pretty straightforward. You get Imperial Scrolls, and with those Imperial Scrolls, you just draw to get a bunch of commander sculptures. The key thing here is that you cannot select commanders that you do not own. So basically this event is not to summon the commanders that you do not own, but it is to get sculptures for your existing commanders. Let's select all these expertise though. Let me select this guy and go like this, confirm. I need some Imperial Scrolls and then select this, match. This is the test server, I cannot, but basically this is how you play it. You select your commanders, you select how many Imperial Scrolls that you want to spend, and then you click on confirm and hopefully you will get a bunch of sculptures. The next one on the list, Verdant Picnic, Spring Secrets, and Wondrous Wilderness. These events are tied to each other. You gather candies with multiple actions, map gathering, city collection, or defeating barbarians. Then you donate your candies to receive Easter eggs or either this thing if you spend your gems, but I don't recommend you to. And then once you have enough, you can exchange them for like sculptures, city themes. And for my fellow cavalry players, if you missed the previous 5% cavalry health city skin, we have another one. This is the only health skin. We have archer attack, we have infantry attack. I don't really like attack, as you guys know, but we have cavalry health, which is great. However, on the last event, we also had cavalry health. So if you have it, this is going to be pretty useless. And then we have this thing, of course. You complete and claim your quests. You don't need to do anything specific. You just need to play it regularly, like gather resources, log in, defeat barbarians, help alliance members. Like, these are the things that you are going to do it anyway. And in return, you get a bunch of extra rewards. War of the Ruins is, again, pretty straightforward. It's like a one-on-one deathmatch. And the only reason, basically, you want to play it is because it gives Legendary Commander Sculpture, Straw Bonnet, and Easter Eggs. And then we have Arms Training. This, I would say, one of the better events in the game. I also have a dedicated guide for Arms Training as well, so make sure to check it out. And if you manage to get Rank 1, 20 Legendary Commander Sculptures. I'm not saying that it's easy. However, you can definitely, by abusing certain mechanics, I've explained it in that video, you can really get a high rank, even though you're not the biggest spender in your kingdom. Barbarian Incursions, we recently had it. Ian's Ballads, Silk Road, Olympia, of course. And this one basically showing you the city skins that you can get during the event. As I said, Spring Blossom is definitely the best one because it is the only one that gives you 5% HP. On top of the events, one of the main things that I wanted to show you guys is the new season of Conquest Story, Alliance Invictus. And I think this story is going to be pretty fun to play because, yes, we do have support skills. That's something that we are already familiar with. We have Bastions, of course. However, now we have something called Curio. We have Riding Crop, this is for cavalry, Footsman Pledge for infantry, Bowsman Pin for archers, and Besieger Brooch. I don't know who plays with siege units, but it's good to know that we do have it as well. And here it also explains that if a troop secondary commander is equipped with this Curio, all units in the troop will be converted into cavalry units. So you can be using archers, you can be using infantry, but if your secondary, let's say you are using Nevsky Joan, and Joan of Arc has this Curio, then all troops, all units in that troop will be converted into cavalry, which is, I think, going to enable a lot of different possibilities. Keep in mind that Curios do not work in the Lost Canyon or Sunset Canyon, and they do not affect units garrisoned in your city. It's only for your march, and converted units will be treated, of course, as their new unit type when calculating skills and talent effects. So regardless of the troop type that you are left with, by using these Curios, you can convert these troops into the troop type of your choice depending on the Curio that is equipped by your secondary commander. And I think it's good that they're adding something to secondary commanders, because only thing that's working for secondaries is the skills. The talents doesn't work, the equipment doesn't work. And Curio, I think, is going to be, like, it's a good addition that increases the importance of your secondary commanders. And in this season of Conquest Story mode, we do also have something called Alliance Outposts. Alliance flags can be upgraded into outposts, and these outposts have all the functionality of an alliance flag, but on top of that, it can be used to loan troops to your alliance. Your alliance leader and officers can use these loan troops to garrison buildings or launch rallies. So you won't be able to loan troops for field fighting, but you'll be able to loan troops for garrison and rallies. And I think the main reason of it is because the number of players, or I should say the number of accounts, can go into a season of conquest KVK from one kingdom has been capped, which did affect kingdoms with a lot of farm accounts. I mean, I should say filler accounts, because there are two different farm accounts. There are regular farm accounts that you just get resources, or there are filler accounts that you don't really field fight with those accounts, but what you do is you reinforce garrisons, you reinforce rallies. And with that limitation, it did hurt the kingdoms that were relying on those filler accounts. Now, with the alliance outposts, your alliance leader and officers, as I said, will be able to loan troops instead of those filler accounts for garrison and rallies. So this new season of Conquest Story Mode and also upcoming events were the main things that I wanted to showcase to you guys. And of course, there are a bunch of improvements and other adjustments. Feel free to read the whole patch notes, but if I try to go over them one by one, this video will be like an hour. So hope you guys liked it, hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to subscribe for more Rise of Kingdoms videos. I see you on the next one. Oh, and also, a new account update video is on the way. Stay tuned. Goodbye.